Release! So it comes to this!
Ah, you are returned. Were your negotiations with the Wolfman successful?
The one they called the White was receptive to our words once we told him of Doma's liberation. They withdrew behind the walls to inform their brethren. If the gods are good, no blood shall be shed between our peoples this day.
Hear, hear! Now, I think it's time we did something about those gates. Touches forward! Give me Hellfire! Give me Ifrit's bloody inferno! Now give me a curse and winter! Enough ice and snow to bury a behemoth! All cannons! Fire at will! Let no man say we neglected to knock! Damn that armor! We nearly had it!
Is that...
Bear witness, my Eorzean brothers and sisters! Doma is come to pay her debts!
Lord Hian!
We will deal with the flying machines! Forward, my friends! For freedom and justice!
Resume firing!
We're through. The way is clear. to share these findings.
Initiate soul extraction. Ha! Success!
The soul rebels! This moment lasts. Yes! Yes! Just so! Have you the strength? The power to transcend!
Yes! Yes! Such ferocity! Such tenacity! I am loath to recall how disappointed I was when first we fought. But finally... finally! After bathing in the blood and offal of your enemies, finally you prove yourself worthy prey for the hunt. It fills you even now, doesn't it? The hunger to bite down on my jugular, to feel the warmth fill your mouth and run over even as you drink deep. Good. Good. This is the beast I have longed to face. As you sharpen your claws, I too sought newfound strength. But this is no place for a final contest. Come! The heavens shall bear witness to our dance. Welcome to the Royal Menagerie. The King of Ruin built this place for his foreign queen. He kept it filled with familiar creatures from her homeland. They bored me all. This fine specimen, on the other hand, simply divine. Your fates are entwined, are they not, Icon Slayer? This dragon, this embodiment of unbridled despair, born of a desperate man's burning hatred for the Empire. How raw the raging tempest that churns within its breast. No myth made manifest this, but a being of pure violence. Mayhap you are the true architect of our design. You, who fought the very soul of vengeance to the edge and watched him fall. You, who let slip the Elegon Hound to drive this icon into my arms. Oh my, have I said too much? Forgive me, this sensation is wholly unfamiliar to me. A question, then, and I should like very much for you to speak from the heart. If I were to stand aside, what would you do to this icon? Ah, as simple as that. But of course, you are the Icon Slayer, and such certainty is to be expected. A pity. There is another alternative. Or there would be, had you only mastered your abilities. I speak of the Echo, of course. Does it merely render you immune to iconic influence, or is it rather that your influence is far greater than theirs? Granted, these implications are of no moment to a savage who thinks only of killing the beast before him. But when I read Van Belsar's reports, I immediately saw the boundless potential of the Echo. I saw how it could be instrumental in binding an icon to one's will. Hence my research and the Resonant, and know so much more. All icons must be exterminated without exception. Such was the Imperial mandate issued by my great-grandfather after he saw firsthand the destruction wrought by one such being. They are a blight upon this star, he felt. And so he began his great and just crusade.
Ha! 'Twas not justice which spurred his campaign, but fear! Fear of the Icons! Fear of their power! Cowardice made them march forth to battle. Pathetic. Man should fight for the joy of it. To live, to eat, to breed. Lesser beasts snap and howl at one another for this. Only man has the wisdom and the clarity to embrace violence for its own sake. For we who are born into this merciless, meaningless world have but one candle of life to burn. I know you understand this. You and I are one and the same. Together, we could while away the quiet hours as friend and confidant, if you would accept me. And yet, in doing so, you prove me right. We are warriors. 'Twas plain from the first how this would end. You live for these moments, when all hangs in the balance, when the difference between life and death is but a single stroke. I live for them too! This is who we are, my friend! This is all we are! Alamigo and Doma and Golemol be damned! The gods, you by your gift, I by my might. And before the resonant, the gods shall be made to kneel.
Are you all right? Xenos.
The hunter has indeed become the hunted. And yet, there is only joy. Transcendent joy that I have never known. How invigorating, how pure this feeling.
Is that what this was all about? All the meaningless death and destruction, so you could feel something?
Meaningless. Men die that others may live. Those who survive are stronger for it. Not that you could ever understand. To have stood upon this great stage of fools. To have played my part to perfection. Oh, this moment. Let it be enshrined in eternity. My heart beating out of time. So clear. So vivid. So real. So real.
Coward!
Stop!
Farewell, my first friend. My enemy.
Where is he?
He's dead. By his own hand.
Then justice has been done.
No. There's no justice in that... in that rabid animal's end.
Liberty or death? That so many should be forced to take up this creed to defeat such madness.
We won. Forget him. The living have need of us now.
Stand tall, Lys. Now is the time to raise a cheer for all who fought for freedom. A cheer loud enough to carry to the highest heavens.
You're right. Thank you. Without you... well, you know. So let's do it together. For Alamigo!
In crimson it began, and in crimson it ended. And then we were free. But what is freedom, really? We may be free to live, to love, to grow old, to have dreams and desires, and to strive for them. But in the end, we're defined by the legacy our forefathers bequeathed to us. Even Xenos was once a baby in the cradle, innocent and pure. He was made into a creature that lived only for death, not born one. 20 years of Imperial rule have left Alamigo torn and bleeding. It won't be easy to heal a generation's worth of wounds, to bridge the gap. But I won't give up, Papalimo. I won't. Because I remember the price of freedom. I remember the smoke and the ashes and the blood. I remember the screams and the silence. And I'll do whatever it takes to honor their sacrifice, to build a home for us all. I promise you. This is the end. The end of the Imperial province of Alamigo, and the rebirth of Alamigo, the free nation. Long may she endure.
Well, well, well. What a fine mess we've made.
All but spent feeding that primal, eh? Well, you won't be making any mischief with that amount of ether. Still, better safe than sorry. There. There ends your hateful legacy.
We've been through a lot together, haven't we? I can't thank you enough. There's something I need to say to you all. That is, if you have a moment. Good. You're all here. Good. Good. Thank you doesn't really suffice, does it? I'm grateful. Truly grateful from the bottom of my heart. But I know you didn't fight so hard just to hear me or anyone else say that. You fought because you wanted to help, because you believed it was right. Because you're Scions. Now, I'm obviously a Scion, but as Conrad left me in charge of things here, I also have responsibilities to Alamigo. When I put it like that, though, I realized I couldn't even pretend to be impartial anymore. So it seemed best to make it official. As long as I serve Alamigo, I can't be a Scion. It might be selfish and short-sighted, but that's my decision.
Am I to understand that you summoned us all, some of us still nursing wounds, to hear this?
Oh, I didn't...
Forgive me, Lise. 'Twas but a jest. But this I say with the utmost sincerity. Scion or no, we are comrades, now and ever after. Is that not so? There you have it. Come what may, you may count on us in your hour of need. We shall never refuse you.
Stola. Oh, gods. I swore I wouldn't cry.
Come back here, you slippery little devil. Ah, to think fishing could be so difficult. What greater proof of a man's lingering mortality than an empty belly? A fate worse than death. Fie on it. Have arrived at the appointed place and time only to survive by mere force of habit. Truly, the Kami are not finished with us yet. Oh, capricious fortune. How you test me with this wretched soul.
Hmm.